Hello, comic fans. Here's Earl Grey with my top 10 European graphic novels. This is my last of this short series about my favorite standalone volumes. I've already did two videos with the ranks 30 to 11. And now it's my proper top 10. And if my accent is a bit weirder than usual, blame it on this juice here. It's Federweißer. Some call it new wine. It's half fermented grape juice, so it's not a proper wine yet. Cheers. But it's sweet, tastes a bit like this Monster lemonade, but good with alcohol instead of caffeine. So yeah, I've warned you, if this video will get a bit off the track, you know why. But I wanted to do this video here to complete this short series. So let's start quick. With rank 10, Dieter Lumpen, written by the Argentinian, actually, Georges Centenaire, and drawn by the Spaniard Ruben Pellegero, who drew the new, or draws the recent new Corto Maltese stories. You can see that his drawing style is a very good fit for that classic comic. Maybe some who know this comic here would say this is rather a series of short stories and some stories with album length. And they're right, of course, but I thought, hey, it fits between these two covers here. It's all in one book, so I call it a graphic novel or a standalone issue, especially since by far my favorite in this book here is the last one. And this is a fantastic ambiguous story about life and death and storytelling. A bit in the way Neil Gaiman uses mythology. This uses mythology as well. Even the three sisters are part in it. A big surprise. And Dieter Lumpen here. Oh. Talking about chaotic video. Dieter Lumpen, this is a very German sounding name. Lumpen means in German, means old cloth or a guy, a being of a questionable character. And this is all true for this central anti-hero, Dieter Lumpen, who is thrown into the stories, into his adventures, and he has no control about what happens to him. He's like driftwood in these stories. And there is an English edition by IDW from this book here. As it is with The Land of the Suns. This is actually English Fantagraphics, of course. Written and drawn by the Italian Gippy, and Wikipedia told me that he does movies as well, and you can see it in this comic here. It's very cinematic, though he uses this minimalistic style, just his drawings. But I like this kind of art where you can see every line and it's all handmade and very moody. And I was very surprised when I bought it. I bought it because of Fantagraphics, because I liked the art, but I thought it was a bit of this artsy graphic novel, end of the world scenario stuff that I'm actually not every day have the mood for. But this book here, you can read it every day in the week and you're gripped emotionally, and it's very engaging, very fun. Talking about mood and atmosphere, Louis Tal, one of my favorite French comic creators, there was no question that I had to include one of his books. And since I've decided, as I've told you in the other videos that I've done before, that I wanted to include just one book of each creator, so I had to decide which one. And Bisame Mucho, I don't know how to pronounce it, even though it's a very famous music piece that gave this comic its title. And it's told in Louis Tal's typical way of doing comics, pictures with subtitles. So some of you won't call it an actual comic, but his art is, many panels are so beautiful that you don't want to place a bubble in these pictures here. Would hurt a bit this atmosphere, this. So I'm totally fine with it. And this book here is really amazing. On rank 7, we have again a book from Fantagraphics, The Adventures of Yodel, drawn by Guy Pellard, a Belgian guy. Comic Crack had shown it in one of his videos some years ago, and I instantly had to have it when I saw it. It's because of the colors, because of the... This book is just beautiful. And I like this over-the-top pop art style. It imagines a future, sort of future world, where the ancient Romans are still in power, and yeah, it's just crazy. But Barbarella is in a way pretty naive and simplistic, but this here is even more naive and in a great way simplistic and colorful, of course. Highly recommended. I mean, it's Fantagraphics. I think you should be able to hunt one of these books down. More classic, more generic in a way, but I love it, is rank 6, A Voyage to Holidays in Italy, A Voyage to Italy, something like this, by the Swiss Cose, Eine Reise nach Italien, 1 und 2. It's a love triangle, two friends fell for the same girl. A topic that was the basis for a zillion French movies, I know, but yeah, this here really adapts this theme, this trope for comics and in a great way. And as the old Monty Pythons used to say, now to something completely different. Die Heere des Eroberers, the troops of the Emperor. Here, the old Volksverlag version. I don't know, absolutely don't know if there is an English publication, but I think since this was published in Metal Hurlant and in the German Schwermetall, of course, it has to be in the American heavy metal. So maybe these drawings, if you ever have come across the stuff here, you would remember it. I'm pretty sure. It shows the atrocities of this ancient imperialism in all its detail, but a bit like a fairy tale, but like a grim fairy tale. Written by Jean-Pierre Dionnet, I guess he was one of the chief editors of Metal Hurlant, and drawings by Jean-Claude Gall. This is actually the only comic I think I can think of that he's drawn or that I know of, which is a bit strange because this stuff here is very impressive. Now to rank 4. Teufelsmaul, the French original title escapes me right now. The mouth of the devil or something like that. Devil's mouth, referring to his deformed lips here of the main character, a child in the Cold War, brought up by in a Russian military school pensionat. It's a very grim, depressing story, drawn by one of the best comic artists that I know of, a French artist. Very, yeah, very grim, very depressing, but pretty real in terms of getting a hold of you and makes you think about these times. And yeah, François Büchs art is really not out of this world, and he draws, maybe he draws the ugliest humans in comics. There is no embellification to them, but it fits a title like this one, 100%. Now to one of these creators where I had really a hard time picking one of them for the books. And I think of all of the fans of Lorenzo Mattotti, I'm the one who would choose this book here, The Man at the Window, Der Mann am Fenster. Written by Lilia Ambrosi, it's very un-Mattotti-ish, and yeah, I did a video about Mattotti's art, or I think even two, and so you can check out his other works on my channel. But yeah, I can't lie, this book here had the biggest impact on my feeling towards comics, what comics can do, and what just some mere lines in a box can achieve in terms of telling a complex story. And this is just such a great piece of art here. Yeah, and again, a lot of you would disagree and say, Mattotti, yes, but oh, why not Garlandia, his recent book, which is not in color, no color as well, or some of his colored work like Fire or Murmur. All great books, but however, I had to decide, and I have a pretty good hand in mispicking tardy books in my crime selection, favorite crime album, European album series. I made Adele my number one, and some comments made me aware that even Jacques Tardy doesn't like Adele too much. Adele is my favorite, so is hier selbst. Mem ici or ici même. The French title, Yourself or I, myself or something like that. I think you will find this book here. It stands out among the books of Jacques Tardy. It's about this this gatekeeper who lives on the walls of some compound that he doesn't own anymore, but he has inherited the walls and he stays on the walls, and he lives from the toll that he gets from the people who has to pass these walls. So it's a bit silly premise, but what Jacques Tardy makes out of the story is a saga of that Franz Kafka couldn't have made it better. I know Franz Kafka's name is used way too often in terms of describing comics, but here it really fits. It's surreal, it's entertaining, it's funny, it's unique. So, number one, of course, It's the Night by Philippe Drouillet. I mean, this is just an exceptional, crazy comic, almost without a story, an elementary outcry. And if you never have heard about this one here, go get it or watch at least one of my videos about Philippe Drouillet. More, you can't get more orange, more green, more screaming colors and more intricate yet loose line work, artistic endeavors than in this book here. Even in this Titan edition that I had some beef with, more about this in my special video about Drouillet's Night. So, I'm really glad that I made it to the end of this little video here. Actually, I spoke a minute ago of one Pierre Drouillet, so I had to edit this out. And you see, Federweiser is out as well, and maybe this is a good thing. Don't drink and drive. Thanks for listening and watching. Goodbye.